the aircraft during the Battle of Britain. He was also a highly successful yachtsman and founded the London Boat Show. Though the former sail loft is open to the public at select times, it is also his daughter's dining room. The sumptuous dinner parties given here have included royalty.
The Prince of Wales dined here.
Yeah, the Prince of Wales dined here. I sat next to him. It was Admiral's Cup sailing dinner, I remember.
What happened?
Well, not what my father was expecting, I don't think.
Well, what was that?
That he'd fall mad in love with me and propose, I think. I was about 17 at the time.
He might have been all for the best if he had.
I think I was a lucky escape, didn't you?
Whether Sir Max would have agreed is another matter. The room is full of his sailing trophies, but there are also souvenirs from the war.
This is Hitler's dagger from the bunker.
Actually, Hitler's dagger.
Yeah, it was presented by Stalin to my grandfather, Lord Beaverbrook. And apparently it was Hitler's. You can see the swastika here. It's a pretty nasty bit of work, isn't it?
Look.
Can you imagine? He actually held out Hitler.
Hitler himself. How extraordinary. But most of the things here, presumably, are nautical.
Most are nautical. There's some great and wonderful paintings like these loonies here. There's all sorts of different artefacts, bits and pieces.
Did your father collect them?
He collected them all, yes. People used to give him things as well, but on the whole, he collected them all.
How did you get on with your father?
Oh, very well. I was the youngest, and it always helps being the youngest.
Because he was a sort of fairly butch...
He was very glamorous. He was a very glamorous man.
A sort of man's man.
I suppose so. I mean, he was a great offshore sailor, and he introduced powerboat racing to Europe, which is now huge in Italy. And this lunch, funny enough, is for the foreign drivers who come over racing this weekend.
Laura, too, has been a competent powerboat racer in her time.
I'm retired now. My crash helmet is hung up.
You've hung it up?
Yeah. Busy having babies.
What's this?
This is my cradle. That says Laura's cradle. When I was a baby, it was built for me by Arthur Fox, who was a great yacht designer.
He was the man that taught the Prince of Wales to sail.
That's right.
The Aitken pool is very cleverly designed because you can't see it from either the main street or the busy harbour. Living at the Prospect is something I could adapt to quite easily, and what an environment for children.
And it's great because it just looks over the water here, yeah.
Through the Daily Express Crusader.
It's this magnificent window, isn't it? In the hurricane, in the 87 hurricane, everything else blew down, but it was still left in its frame by itself there.
The Daily Express survives everything.
Absolutely.
How wonderful to be brought up in a house surrounded by the sea on three sides, watching the boats go by. Laura's husband, Martin Levy, and Sonny, her 8-year-old from her first marriage, love living here.
Martin and Sonny.
Hi there.
Hello. You caught anything?
They may not catch much, but it's quite extraordinary to be able to fish from one's front door.
Are you going to show me these boats?
Yeah.
I suppose this is the cow's equivalent of a family runabout, isn't it?
Yeah,
To have one's own means of water transport tethered to one's front terrace is rather civilised, even if one does have to use a little muscle power to lower it into the water.
Okay, have a good time. Come on, Sonny.
And now it's time for the lads to play. We're off to the big boys' toy shop where the power boats are getting ready for tomorrow's race.
What's the top speed on a boat like that?
A boat like that's doing about 90, 95 miles an hour.
On water?
On water.
So what's the equivalent on land?
Double it, and you're close.
So it's like traveling...
200 miles an hour on land.
How much does it cost to put a boat like that together?
£1 million to be a front-line competitive boat.
£1 million?
More, if you want.
These boats go 100 miles an hour. How would I get started?
Turn the key.
All right, turn the key. I want to be a glamorous powerboat racer. Other than paying £1 million to get started, how do I get started, Martin?
make friends with somebody who has a healthy bank balance, who owns a race boat, and go in as a passenger.
Do the guys get paid for this?
On the whole, they don't. There are only a handful of powerboat racers who are professional in the sense that they're paid to race. Most people
pay
to race.
£1 million of boat is a lot of pay.
Martin should know. His Italian father, Sonny Levy, who designed this early classic model in 1963, is one of the gurus of powerboat design. Martin runs the family business with him, and their record is impressive. Several hundred winners in Class 2 and over 20 Class 1 winners.
What's the most famous boat that your family have done?
Some years ago, we designed a boat for Richard Branson to beat the transatlantic.
And did he?
Record crossing. He did, yeah. It was in just under 3 days.
What kind of people do it? What kind of man decides to become a powerboat racer?
Good question.
What does it take?
I think it takes a few screws loose.
Guts, presumably.
It's quite hairy.
So why are the Italians so keen on it?
I think it's got something to do with TV coverage.
It's a big sport in Italy.
The drivers are known like racing drivers and cars are here.
And they enjoy the same kind of macho status.
Macho status and very glamorous.
Before I get accused again of being sexist, let's not forget that Laura's mother, Lady Vi, as she's known, was a first-class racer and Laura was her co-driver. But what was the crowd's reaction to these two women?
It's extraordinary. I mean, as if you're something, you know, that came down from the moon. I mean, you get people saying, "Hey, look, he's got long hair. It's a woman." And as if, you know, you've never seen a woman on a boat before. Quite extraordinary.
It's the night before the race, and Cowes is welcoming the competitors in traditional style. The gin is flowing freely at Prospect, and I only hope they haven't been celebrating as indulgently as we have, because tomorrow is going to be a tough day. It's already 9:30, and no one is stirring indoors. Laura's decided to watch the race from the balcony, but I want to get out to where the action is. The start boat is for me the place to be for the race. You get the best view and you get to motor alongside these magnificent machines until they disappear. The race is from Cowes to Torquay and back. When they open up, it's truly dramatic. So why on earth has it been so slow to take off in this country?
It hasn't been taken up by television. In Italy, for example, the drivers who are here this weekend are household names. They're as famous as their footballers. Nowadays, if they can make bowls and darts exciting, you would think there'd be a huge market for something glamorous like powerboating.
But just how dangerous is the sport? Martin's father, Sonny Levy, was a racer as well as a designer, and he knows just how hazardous it is.
I suppose every year a couple of chaps bite the spray.
Fatally. What drives them on?
I suppose it's the thrill of going fast through the water, because you get a tremendous sensation of speed. In the big offshore boats, there is a lot of skill if the conditions are tough. In a smooth race, it's fairly easy.
I mean, could I do it?
Yes, I'm sure you could.
I mean, to a layman, it looks as if you're trying to ride a motorbike across a whole series of logs, the logs being the waves. Is it rough? Does it feel bouncy? Does it hurt?
Well, it does. You're certainly bounced around in the boat, and in fact, in the first race I ever did, I cracked 7 ribs. And I had no idea that I'd done this till I stepped ashore.
What's the most painful thing that happened to you when you were racing?
Broke my
Fingernail?
It's physically quite tough, but I mean, as we all know, women can be physically tough as men. Certainly, I mean, I spend a lot of money at the osteopath now. A lot of money. I mean,
as a consequence of Harbour racing.
Yeah, we used to have huge double neck braces under the crash helmet, and I think it did more neck damage and stuff than anything else.
I think the only accident he had was opening the bottle of champagne.
This year, a Norwegian boat won, and I was here to see it all. It was a perfect ending to a perfect day to a perfect weekend.